Welcome to the sixth video in a series designed to provide guidance with using SRH2D for sediment transport modeling. In this video, we will be discussing the special topic of modeling cohesive sediment. Lesson topics will include an overview of the characteristics of cohesive material, an introduction to the erosion and deposition behavior of cohesive material, and the specific parameters SRH2D requires to perform this type of modeling. In broad terms, most material found in a river system is non-cohesive material. Cohesive sediment refers to the sediment that is smaller than sand, with an intermediate access length smaller than 0.0625 millimeters. In sediment transport discussions about the full range of material sizes, it's common to refer to cohesive material as silt and clay. Expanding on the smaller classes, silt is the description of the next class smaller than sand and has the further descriptors of coarse, medium, fine, and very fine, which represents the transition from the fully non-cohesive properties of sand to the fully cohesive properties of clay. All material smaller than very fine silt is clay. In the field, soils with high silt and clay content can be identified by some easily observable properties. High silt content soil is smooth to the touch, does not hold shape well if formed by hand, and does not retain water well. High clay content soil feels sticky, is easily moldable, and will hold water well when a sample is picked up. Remembering these properties can be helpful when assessing the site in the field and developing a sense of how a model should perform. And it is important to remember that the 2D model simplifies both types of sediment into one class that has a cycle of transport behavior that is different from the non-cohesive classes. Cohesive material on a channel bed that has been undisturbed for a period of time will form a consolidated surface that is quite resistant to erosion. When erosion does occur, it begins with surface erosion, where individual or small aggregates of material called flocks are entrained in the water column. Then, as shear stress increases, mass erosion, where failures occur in the consolidated surface and large chunks of material are eroded at once. Once lifted into the water column, turbulent forces mix the material, causing both further segregation of larger groups and aggregation of smaller groups. The concentration of material in the water column influences this behavior. Below an equilibrium concentration, large flocks are not formed, and smaller flocks remain in suspension with no deposition occurring. As the concentration increases, large flocks form and deposition can occur. When deposition happens, it occurs in two phases. Full deposition occurs when the shear stress is lower than a critical threshold and all material is deposited. Partial deposition occurs at shear stresses lower than this critical threshold, such that strongly bonded flocks are deposited but still strong enough to break up weak flocks and keep them in suspension. Once deposited, the relatively small flocks bond with existing material on the channel bed in a partially consolidated state. Under the pressure of the water column, the bond strength increases and density of the layer increases with time, creating an erosion-resistant consolidated layer. SMS provides users with access to the single-layer mode of modeling cohesive sediment transport. With this feature, the model assumes the smallest size class entered is cohesive and applies the following parameters. What makes cohesive modeling especially challenging is that some of the properties that drive the erosion and deposition must be derived from testing a sample in a lab setting. There are no general guidelines or default values that will produce useful modeling results. The first parameter in the cohesive modeling section is bulk density. SMS will assume a bulk density for the partially consolidated cohesive layer to be 30 pounds per cubic foot. In this field, the user specifies the bulk density of the fully consolidated layer. For fall velocity, the user is likely to use either properties of standard kaolinite, which is a common clay, data specific to the Severn River in Great Britain, or provide a data file of fall velocity by concentration. In the format of this file, comment lines are preceded by a double backslash and two columns of data, concentration in kilograms per cubic meter and fall velocity in millimeters per second are specified. Critical shear stress and surface erosion constants for the surface and mass erosion processes are entered next, along with the specified units. These values are usually obtained from lab tests of a field sample, and meaningful values must be entered to have useful results. Alternatively, the modeler can specify an input file. The file format is two columns of data, with shear stress in Pascal units and erosion rate in kilograms per meter squared per hour. Depositional parameters are entered next, with critical shear stresses for full and partial deposition and the equilibrium concentration that indicates when deposition can occur, along with specified units. These values do not come from lab testing and are more likely to be adjusted during calibration. With all these values entered, the model control window is complete and the simulation is ready to execute. This concludes the video on the special topic of modeling cohesive sediment, which included a discussion of the characteristics of cohesive material, an introduction to the erosion and deposition behavior, and the specific parameters SRH2D requires to perform this type of modeling. For more information on additional videos, documents, and other reference material about two-dimensional modeling in SMS, please navigate to the link provided here.